Welcome back to the channel. It's our last full day in China, and this is what it's like exploring Beijing.
We just got kicked off a bus.
You should come to China. It's very cool.
We're doing one of our favorite things to do while traveling, which is going to the mall, which is funny because we do not like going to the mall back home. And we're going to try and figure out the bus. We just got kicked off a bus for some reason, and now we're waiting for a second one to come. This looks right. Okay, we're leaving the mall now, and we are going to go to a beautiful park.
Yeah.
And probably the weirdest thing about being here in China is about one out of every five people, they will just stare at us in complete shock and bewilderment. I don't know what else they're thinking, but it is kind of hard to get used to. Okay, but let's go to the park. Just got off the subway, but I'll never get used to how jam-packed they are. Like, it's just shoulder to shoulder. You can't move or talk or do anything.
And you're just getting shoved around, people trying to get on and get off.
Yeah, okay. Let's find the exit.
Not this way. This way. Okay, some fun facts about China. There are 1.4 billion people who live in all of China, and 22 million live just in Beijing, which is the capital city, and that's half the population of all of Canada in one city. So there's a lot of people here. So to try to control the pollution in China, especially in Beijing, they have a system with the cars where if your license plate ends in a certain number, then you can't drive for a couple days of the week or something like that. So most people who own a car can't drive there's 2 days per week that you can't drive your car. And also to have a car, there's a lottery system. So it's very rare to get the chance to even own a car here, which is why most people take the metro.
And then the license plates are also many different colors. Blue means it's electric and you can drive any day of the week, and then yellow is diesel. And like Shay said, if you do win the lottery, most people will buy one or two cars. So the plan for the rest of the day, we are gonna go to Olympic Park and look around there. That's where the 2008 Beijing Olympics were held. And then we really wanna try Peking duck before we leave China. So we're gonna find that for dinner.
Okay, we just made it in the park. We had to buy two tickets to enter the park, which was 2 yen each, which is like 50 cents each or something. Now we're gonna walk around.
As soon as you enter the park, it's like entering another world. I did not expect to see this in Beijing. There's people playing sports, a guy exercising with his sword, and it's super relaxed and tranquil.
more in the park, and we decided to try some Chinese drinks, and we're gonna try some Chinese smiley ice cream. How is it?
Really, really good. Look, it looks like Walter White from Breaking Bad. So good.
Restaurant, and we ordered Peking duck, some dumplings, and rice. They had a very extensive menu and no English version, so it was a bit hard to order and go through the whole extensive long menu that they have. So we got three things. We'll see how it turns out.
Dish number one, all these dumplings are like $2.
Look at all those dumplings.
Wow. Holy crap. That's incredible. What do you think?
Oh, wow. Super good.
Is holy crap good?
Yeah. This might be the best dumpling I've ever had. We might have ordered a bit too much food, but we're gonna try to eat all of this.
Okay, we ordered way too much food, but here's how we did. And I'm so full right now, I feel sick. Most of the dumplings are gone. There's the duck. And two full bowls of rice still.
Not too bad.
Alright, China checklist. We went to the Great Wall. We ate Peking duck. We hung out in a park with locals. And I think we crushed it.
Yeah.
We can't wait to come back someday, but that's not the end of the video. Because now we're going back to the hotel. And then we're going to go to...
The Olympic Plaza. Thing.
Yeah. We feel so bad for ordering so much food and then not eating it, so hopefully there's some sympathy for us, because we don't speak the language, obviously. But we feel bad leaving all that food, so I did want to ask if there's other people who wanted to eat it, but again, we don't speak the language.
Okay, we made it back to our hotel room, and I'm gonna do a quick tour. Our room is pretty small, as most of the rooms in China, or at least in Beijing, are that we saw, but I'm gonna show you around now. All right, here is our bathroom. Shower. Fridge. Small bed. Messy room. All the basics, but a few random things like this machine that we don't know what it does. And over here we have this machine that we don't know what it does. And here is our view from our window. Nothing too exciting.
Alright guys, we have officially made it to Olympic Park, and yet again they do not miss our opportunity to do a security check. We had to go put our bags through a scanner again, but we made it and we're gonna go check it out. It looks pretty sweet. Let me show you now. Okay, we have the famous water cube right there. It looks really cool. It's glowing even. We have the National Indoor Stadium. There's something going on in the eagle's nest back there. China knows how to build things big.
Yeah.
We're always surprised how big everything is here, and we always underestimate it. It's so cool.
so we're gonna go now, but stadium's right there. It's so cool.
This is China. We went to freaking China. It's so cool. You should come here. I don't want to say. You should come to China. It's very cool. Thank you so much for watching these videos, and we'll see you in our next country. Good night.